Hello aspirants, looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14th November. On the front page you have this news: Supreme Court refuses to stay Sabarimala ruling. So the Sabarimala ruling, which has allowed women of all age groups to visit the shrine here, a petition has been introduced as such. Review pleas are proposed to be heard, but Supreme Court has refused to stay this ruling. Means this ruling has to be put into effect. All women should be allowed entry into the Sabarimala temple. Then this is Sri Lanka court stays dissolution, snap elections. So further development in Sri Lankan politics, we saw how the president of Sri Lanka, Maithripala Sirisena, had dissolved the house because the party which he was supporting, which he represents, did not have majority. So the courts have been approached. The Sri Lankan Supreme Court has now stayed the dissolution of the house too and the snap elections which had been announced. Then next is government asks Twitter to help track accounts. So this is regarding central government taking the help of microblogging site Twitter to furnish telephone numbers and other identifiable sources that could help track suspicious accounts. So this is what the government is demanding from Twitter. And this is Binny Bansal resigns as Flipkart CEO. So Binny Bansal, the Flipkart group which had recently had a merger with Walmart, it is now being seen that Binny Bansal has resigned on some earlier charges which had been allegations which had been against him. Then this is government crop insurance scheme losing steam. So this is a coverage which says that more than 84 lakh farmers, which account for around 15% of the total farmers of the country, have been insured in the first year of the center's ambitious scheme Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. In 2016-17, they have withdrawn themselves from the scheme in 2017-18. So this is the coverage here. Then on page 5, you have this news. Countdown begins for F1 powerboat racing. So 9 teams for 12 countries have reached Amravati in Andhra Pradesh. So here the boat race is going to take place in River Krishna. And this is the full coverage of the front page news. Is crop insurance scheme losing steam? Then on page 7 you have this news. Avni, two chances to tranquilize mist. So this is regarding Avni T1, the tigress which had been killed in Yavatmal in Maharashtra by a civilian hunter. And this is new index to check ease of doing agribusiness. So center is going to reward high performing states through this index. So this may be initiated now. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Four Corners. So this is regarding the Quad grouping. The Quad comprises of India, Australia, Japan and USA. So it says Quad members still face the challenge of defining its common agenda. So they are actually against China in the South China Sea in Indo-Pacific region. Then this is changing trends. So this is regarding OPEC, Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, which is an oil cartel. They decide the production of oil, how much oil should be produced and released in the market and what should be the price as the consequence. So this is a meeting of OPEC and its allies in December will decide the future course of oil prices. Then the lead article is regarding Sri Lanka's national crisis. You can skip. This is a reality check on cooperative federalism. So it says it is yet to be tested on issues related to GST. So cooperative federalism, whether GST also comes within that ambit, that is discussed here. Then on the op-ed page you have this interview with a Pakistani London based historian and author, Farzana Sheikh. So you can skip this too. Then on page 10 you have this news, plea to lift ban on government staff joining RSS activities. So this is a petition which has been initiated. The Government Employees National Confederation, a body affiliated to Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh, has written to the Prime Minister seeking to follow the example of Gujarat and allow them to be part of RSS. Then on international page you have this news, UK-EU agree on Brexit agreement draft. So this raises the prospect of Britain keeping up with the March 29 deadline of exiting from European Union. Then on business page you have this news, Flipkart's Binnie Bansal resigns. So this is after investigation into personal misconduct. So this is what Walmart says, but this is an old case which has been brought to the fore presently, and Binnie Bansal has resigned. Then down here you have this news, after ILNFS, SEBI tightens norms for raters. So we have seen how ILNFS was given a high rating by raters, and this had resulted in the crisis not being evident earlier. So now Securities and Exchange Board of India has tightened the disclosure norms for credit rating agencies. Then there's no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can enroll for our course. You can visit our website aashah.com, and here you can go to the current affairs section and you can download the PDFs here too. The details of current affairs course is also available. You can see the details here. So that is it. Thank you.